Warning, the following video has been rated GN for extreme guitar nerd content. Viewer discretion advised. Today we're checking out Metallica signature guitar picks. Are they a gimmick or are they gold? Let's find out. Welcome to the party, pals. I am Droid. This is the first official episode of the Guitar Zone, a brand new series right here on my channel where we'll nerd out on anything guitar related. Today's episode is all about James Hetfield and Kirk Hammett of Metallica signature Jim Dunlop guitar picks. First up, let's unbox slash unbag slash open them up, shall we? So first up, we're talking the James Hetfield White Fang pick. This is in the Dunlop flow shape, which if you have not checked out the flow picks, highly recommend doing so. I will be making a video specifically all about those picks very soon. Be sure to subscribe for that. Differences between the standard flow picks and the White Fang. First and foremost, the obvious custom graphics. On one side, you got the wolf. And on the other, Hetfield, White Fang. These graphics are purely cosmetic, although that wolf does look pretty BA, wouldn't you say? Maybe we'll go down by the bay and eat some hay. I just may. Second difference, the color, not purely cosmetic. Always a big fan of white colored guitar picks, as they are much easier to see in the dark or stage lighting. If you are familiar with my YouTube shorts or my Instagram or TikTok, you know I play in different colored lighting, and these picks are much more visible than the standard flow picks, which are all dark colors. Huge plus for this pick. Next up is the grip. The White Fang picks have a slightly different embossed pattern from the standard flow picks, which you cannot see because they're too dark. This, however, really is not very noticeable when in use. I am a big fan of the embossed grip on the flow picks, however, so I am glad to see that that stuck around on the White Fang. Third difference, the bevels on the White Fang are much more gradual than the standard flow picks, which are more flat until the very edge where they round nicely. Once again, I enjoy the bevels on both of these picks, so it's a tie there. You really can't go wrong as far as the bevels and the grip of these picks. Lastly, thickness. The White Fangs come in 0.73, 1.0, and 1.14 millimeter. The last of which is the thickness that I went with, simply because the standard flow picks do not come in the 1.14 millimeter thickness, only in Tortex. The standard flow picks jump from 1 millimeter to 1.5 millimeter. So if 1.14 is your preferred thickness, the White Fang is the way to go. And to be honest, if 0.73 or 1.0 millimeter are your preference, I would go with the White Fang as well, simply because of the white color, once again providing better visibility in dark conditions. Now on to the Kirk Hammett Jazz 3. Once again, obvious change from the standard Jazz 3. The colors. Jazz 3s, though most commonly available in red, are also available in a variety of colors, and the Kirk Hammett picks add to that range with a most excellent neon fluorescent green, as well as a sparkly Sparkleton purple color. Although I do love purple, that colorway is unfortunately a minus because it is less visible in dark / stage lighting. The green, however, makes up for that because it is one of the most visible picks ever. I mean, look at it glow in this blue lighting. Just magnificent. I've said it before, Dunlop should make all of their picks in these neon fluorescent colors. They can make green, orange, pink, whatever. A whole neon line. Hint, hint, Dunlop. Who am I kidding? They're not listening. Or are they? They're not. Another obvious change. That little notch cut out of the top of the pick. I'll be honest, I thought that was all gimmick. We all know Kirk just wanted a heart-shaped pick. I mean, I used these red Jazz 3 picks for 10 plus years before getting these green Kirk Hammett ones. And I actually switched completely to the Kirk Hammett picks for an additional, I don't know, 3 plus years, something like that. Mostly for the color, I will say. But the little notch does make the transition from picking to cupping much easier, very smooth, and thus making it a very surprising plus for the Kirk Hammett Jazz 3. It does, however, lower an already very small surface area of the Jazz 3 pick, so it's definitely not for everyone, but I found it to be a decent feature. Now, I'm not too sure about sound comparisons on guitar picks. Sometimes it can be a big sound difference. Sometimes it can be very minute differences, if any at all. The big thing for me with guitar picks is how they feel in your hand, how they affect your playing, which is actually a really big and often overlooked element of guitar playing. However, it's something that I can only really talk about, and honestly, probably something each player should experience themselves, as it can vary from player to player. I mean, look at how many guitar picks there are. Everyone has their favorites. That being said, I am going to do a quick and simple sound comparison. I mean, maybe I'll be surprised. Maybe there will be sound differences. I don't know. Let's find out. It's going to be one sound patch, my standard tone that I use on a daily basis with effects. As for me, that's how I'd be using a pick, and I'd want to hear how it sounds with that tone, not with a dry signal. For test number one, we'll do some simple chugs. We gotta really look out for the tone differences between the green and sparkly sparkleton purple Kirk Hammett Jazz 3s. The tones are gonna be huge differences. End sarcasm. For copyright reasons, I can't be on here playing Metallica riffs as much as I'd like to do so, and I'm not gonna butcher them and do some copycat riff. So for the next test, it's gonna be a simple lead riff from my original song, Cardinal. It's a riff that I use a lot when testing different guitar picks, so if nothing else, it'll provide me with an opportunity at a shameless plug. The song is available on Spotify, Apple, YouTube, etc. under Droid. JROID and shameless plug. Test number three will be a clean riff once again from my original song, Cardinal. And the final test, a section of the solo from my song, The Bottom, as it has that quick transition I talked about earlier from picking to tapping, allowing me to test the switching functionality and seeing how smooth it is with each pick. See the Red Jazz 3 took multiple attempts at the switching maneuver. It was a little sketchy. As you saw in the Kirk Hammett Jazz 3's smooth transition, first attempt. Alright, and there you have it. Final thoughts. I really, really like both of these picks. So I can definitely say, not gimmick, solid gold. Well, maybe gold-plated, but still, very well done, James, and very well done, Kirk, as well as Jim Dunlop. You created some fine additions to guitar pick collections everywhere. As always, I hope you enjoyed the video. I will be doing more videos like this, so please subscribe. Leave your thoughts in the comments. Let me know what type of pick you like to use, and if there's any guitar picks I should check out / review. Also, again, be sure to check out my music on Spotify, Apple, YouTube, etc. under Droid, J-R-O-I-D. It would be much appreciated. Follow on Instagram, TikTok, all the fine social media platforms. Links are all in the description down below. And as always, stay safe and take care. To play us out, using the James Hetfield White Fang pick, take it away, Droid.